All right, everyone. This is Mark Cabby, and welcome back to the Commonwealth. Or, underneath said Commonwealth, that is. So, how about the video quality, eh? The stutters are gone. Yeah, the bit rate, lowering it from, what I had 30,000, I lowered it to 18,000. Brilliant idea. I don't remember where I saw that on the internet somewhere with that issue. So I do appreciate random internet person that I found. I don't remember the name of it. But that is fixed. The videos are beautifully smooth. The sound is great. Everything is great. So now we have found our sweet spot when it comes to recording specifics. So beautiful stuff. Beautiful stuff. And other than that, no new mods, no new news. I guess that is news technically, but so let's get right into the video. And as you can see, we are right outside Vault 114, the home and temporary residence of Nick Valentine, who came here in search of, well, apparently somebody's missing daughter. So, and so we heard that he, from his, assistant, that he ran into someone by the name of Skinny Malone. And that guy sounds like a gangster. If that's just how I see it. But we'll see. Skinny Malone is the man we're looking out for. All these triggermen just in, where they got. What are those? Suspenders, good God. Suspenders, you know, vests, fedoras, all those things. The gangster life, it seems. So, let's get inside this vault and rescue Nick Valentine and see if he can help us find our son. It's still really cool every time it happens. It really is. Alright, let's see. Because it's like, how big? Okay. Let's see if we can sneak around and get him. What do you think? Can we? No, we can't.
Lots of nifty tech down here.
Shh, God, Piper, shut up. Up. Where? Where? There. Boba Fett. Where? Triggerman. There. Oh, dear God. Oh, did you see? Oh, the eye. Okay. Bringing a baseball bat to a gunfight? Are you dumb? Yes! That's not even a question. Of course you are.
Ours now.
God. Alright. Well, we've made it in and taken down our first two adversaries. What do we have here? The good stuff. I suppose we could check out that terminal to kind of get the idea of what exactly went on here. A Vault 114 jumpsuit, nice. Let's see what. Let's see, welcome, please. We are pleased to welcome. Started the latest endeavor. Outside. Using unique space by if you're building for. Seeing a lot of civilian traffic until construction is fully completed. It is up to you to help maintain security of Vault 114 and experiment from prying eyes without proper clearance. Loose lips sink ships, of course. Yeah. God. Right. So, for the science people only, as mentioned in your briefing, Vault 114 will be hosting high-ranking members of local and state government, local luminaries, business people, and their families. Future members are aware that they will be cohabiting solely with others of Boston's upper class.
Upper class, I can't say me. With the upper class. However, the luxury aspect of this vault has been highly exaggerated to the future residents. Multiple families chosen randomly will live and sleep in single room apartments. Dining and bathing will be in shared quarters. That is disgusting. And amenities will be minimal.
Well, I guess it's not that disgusting, but my brother and I shared a bathroom, but God, that is not okay. I mean, all four families, or multiple families in single room apartments? Oh dear. That does not end well. In addition, we are currently interviewing for the overseer position from many candidates. Our goal is to find someone with no supervisory or government experience, and hopefully with a strong anti-authority bias. Human Resources tells us that that the interview process has vetted many viable candidates. By taking away the luxury and authority these groups saw in surface life, we hope to study their reactions in stressful situations. As such, please do not undermine the new overseer's authority at all during the experiment, even and especially if it may cause physical discomfort, embarrassment, or harm to the residents. God, Vault-Tec were just a bunch of dicks, weren't they? They were just a bunch of dickheads. I mean, that is just disgraceful. God. Why do you need to know the reactions of rich people and non-rich people, you know, apartments and small apartments? Like, what good does that do for anybody? It's just stupid. God. Oh, it's truly just retarded. That really is not a smart thing. Alright, well, beside the point, hoping we can maybe find a weapons bench in here. I kind of need to do a little bit of work. I think I have enough work to perhaps upgrade my hunting rifle here a little bit more. What have we got down here? Oh, what? What kind of grenades do we have? Fragmentation. Let's use those.
So I got a question. Ooh. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that'll go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
I guess that does make sense. I wonder if they do that nowadays. No. Certainly not that much. I know in China they do that, but hey boys, hot potato.
Which one are you?
Hot potato.
Hey, something's out there.
Did it blow? What the? Did it blow? Hot potato! Alright. Again, I'm gonna say it again. Enhanced blood textures. Look at that. Beautifully crafted blood everywhere. Right. Okay. Okay.
What was that?
Shut up, Piper. Gosh. Whoa. So this is kind of, this looks like about how far they got in the vault? Or is this like the reactor area? Or? I have no idea. Oh, come on. Hit him. Hit him again. You pathetic weakling. Got one. Ooh! Oh, he's frickin' legendary. Get him, hit him, come on! Easy. Easy. Up, 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 up. Surprise, bitch! Oh shit, I'm low on ammo. Ooh. That's kinda cool. Okay. Let's do a quick save here. Gee, I don't wanna lose killing all those guys now. Did we have one more? No? I think we might have. Okay. Let's see. I wonder how this fares, because we got a good amount of ammo for this now. I'm wondering how this fares against guys levels enemies like this. Cause it's kind of a little weapon, to be honest with you. Not great, huh? Anything down here? Nope. Bags of cement? Yeah, that doesn't sound light.
Using a stealth boy or something? Oh, what?
Stealth boy? What the? Hot potato. Alright. Too scared? Oh, shite. I was actually gonna loot some stuff up there. That's alright.
Let's get this over.
Bringing a baseball bat to a gunfight. The power of the shotgun fills your head with glory. Was it really that bad? I'm assuming that terminal is just the same as the one we found upstairs, but, you know, never hurts to check, I suppose. Yeah. Alright. Mutt fruit? Okay. Start planting those at our settlements. A lot of them are ghouls, too. He sounds like he was alive before the war, so... I don't know if that has any say in the story of Skinny Malone's gang here, but... Alright, the vault entrance, the official vault entrance. Well, I guess this is deeper into it. So here we go. Okay. Okay, well, this seems to be a good place for a lot of, loot, I suppose. Yeah, a lot of pretty good loot in this place, as I'm assuming will be any other vaults we come across.
Oh. How you doing in there, Valentine? Feeling hungry? Want a snack?
Keep talking, meathead.
Oh, it's Nick.
Give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words.
Ooh, nasty.
Then he struck the name across three times.
Three strikes? In the black book? But I never...
Huh? But I never... Well, you're dead now. Save you the trouble. Be up there in a sec, Nick. I just want to give it a little wing around here. Ooh, I've never checked this door out ever before.
That's it.
Ooh. Oh, that's good loot right there. That is some good loot. Unused enamel bucket. I don't know if that has anything in it, but we're gonna take it anyway. Let's actually go with a quick check. The unused enamel bucket. Let's see. Steel. Fine, we'll keep it. It'll look cool and clean. That's where we were. Right, yep. Alright, let's go talk to Mr. Valentine up there. and see what's the whole deal is with this predicament that he's in. Hello.
Hey, you.
Yo.
I don't know who you are, but we got 3 minutes before they realize muscles for brains ain't coming back.
Gotcha.
Get this door open.
All right. How do we do that? The terminal.
You gotta hack that terminal to open up this door.
Gotcha. Yeah, I just found the password for it, so that'll make it a bit easier. Override controls. Yes. Nick Valentine. How are you doing, brother?
My knight in shining armor.
That's me.
Question is, why does he come all this way? Risk life and limb. An old private eye.
Well, to be exact, I'm finding my son.
My son, Sean, is missing. He was kidnapped. But I don't know who took him or where they went.
Missing kid, huh? Well, you came to the right man. Not the right place. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame.
Huh? Really?
She's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got trouble.
I bet.
And I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk.
Sounds good. All right, Nick. Hold on there, brother. There we have go. Got some stuff.
Here used to be small time. Muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger players. So they found this place.
Some interviews to look at. That's
nice. I don't
know
what happened to the previous owners, but they're not exactly around to charge of rent. Empty vault. Perfect hideout.
Cool. Oh, one second there, Nick. I gotta. For whatever reason, somebody locked their loot box. Right, locked their toolbox. All right, let's roll. Be right after you, friend. Dun, 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 dun. Nice get up there. It's got the old detective look, which is a very cool look, I must say. How did you hear them?
Why does that take so fucking long?
Guess he is a robot.
Hey, Dino, quit razzing that detective and get down here. Where the heck is he?
Same place you're gonna be in about 5 seconds.
It's gonna blow you, bud!
Yes, we're not alone.
Do the stank leg. Do the stank leg. Yeah, come on. Come on, you stupid bastards. There we go.
Not that it's an obby.
Potted you. Potted me. Soap is nice. These guys really aren't the smartest of people, are they? Nope. Ooh. Oh, okay. I thought that looked like a, what do you call it, a bottle cap stash? Another locked toolbox. Why do you lock your toolboxes, bro?
Sweet.
Alright. Well, we found quite a bit of purified water, so let's have a little bit of that. There we go. And let's have a little bit of whiskey too, why not? Keep the spirits up. Whoa, what's my carry weight? 232. Okay. We're getting a little bit close. Alright, Mr. Knee. Mr. Knee? Well, nobody's gonna be cleaning up the floors here anytime soon, don't you worry. All right, unfritz it.
Almost got it. There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
I can only imagine, my friend. I can only imagine.
Huh?
Huh?
Where'd you go?
Look at this stupid idiot. Look at him. Look at him die. Pathetic. Bunch of baseball bat wielding idiots. Really is. Like the Los Angeles Dodgers. Ooh, shots fired. Shots have been fired big time. It's actually a really clean room. I just thought about that. What the?
Ooh. Hell yeah.
Nice. Paint. Never know what you could use that for. Maybe you need to repaint a wall or something.
Nothing but nothing over here.
Nothing but nothing?
Who's there? Nothing. What?
What is that guy's deal? Ooh. Gimme, 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 gimme. What the? Oh. Look at him. Wrinkly old disgusting ghoul. Taken down. There we go.
Something out there.
Mine's better. Mine is better. Can't see it. Can't see it. Muscle rapid. Now we gotta make. Is it? We have a that machine gun, muzzled rapid, yeah, 18 damage, so not as good. Cause those things are heavy. I don't know why they're so dang heavy, but those things are heavy. Plates. Plates are beautiful. Unrusted tin cans. Come on, just give me everything. Ceramic. We need ceramic. We need as much ceramic as we can get. Okay, Nick. Sorry. Sorry. Oh. Just one idiot with a bat again. Did we mess with the wrong crew? Really? Because we've killed every single one of you ugly mugs. Probably. Nope. What the? What the? You dumb ugly ghoul! Shoot him! Oh, what is going on? Death! Let's kill this idiot again. This time your head got blown clean off. All right. Onwards and upwards, Nick. Come on, let's not waste any time. Did he just say hello to goodbye? Same to you. God. Ooh, nice music. We walk in the room. Minding my business. 12 gauges of beauty. All up in your face. Alakazam. Nick! You got an idiot with a baseball bat. Dog jokes! Oh my goodness. Oh. Ooh, missed that last time. Normally, a crate with a few explosives hidden there.
Sweet.
No. But two right away. That's good. That's very nice. Piper liked that, so my Piper... She gets turned on when I open things up, does she? Give me all this stuff. Not that, but you know what. Give me everything. Give me all those. Why did I just take that? You know what? Sorry, Nick. Let's roll.
Stairs. Who built this damn
instructor.
Yeah. All right, let's take it easy here. What do we got grenade-wise? Mine, but no grenades. That is unfortunate. Truly is. Huh? Where'd you come from, ugly? Look what the cat dragged in! An ugly bitch! What's it to ya? Oh my goodness! Cunning Raider right arm? Not that great, no. Getting all these Raider right arms, I figured I'd be at high enough level to move beyond that now, but I guess it is what it is. Nice. Ooh, a locked room. Let's check it out. Ooh, oh. Hello, 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 hello. On a tuxedo. Okay. Master safe. Is this like Skinny Malone's little secret stash?
No way I could pick this.
Yeah, that is very true. We'll take his tuxedo. Why not? Who knows? Maybe we'll need it. Alright. We're ready to roll, Nick.
Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you.
Gotcha.
It's dangerous.
Oh.
Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard.
Where's Piper?
Okay, I got it. But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side.
Oh.
Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
Gotcha. Oh, Piper, come here.
Hey.
You say the word. Looking for something specific?
You're not overloaded, no.
Always on good behavior, aren't you?
You try to be, yeah.
I try to be.
Seems like you're doing better than trying. I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered. Of course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far.
Mm.
I mean, look at Diamond City. A place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change? It's enough to make me want to hang up my hat some days.
What's up with my dialogue? It doesn't seem to be working. The full dialogue thing. Anyways, must be exhausting. Yeah.
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
Huh, no kidding. But people, they deserve to know the truth.
It's true.
Sure, it can be scary knowing what's really out there. A night doesn't go by I'm not afraid some institute drone will decide today's the day to pay old Piper and family a visit.
Oh, come on.
But it's worth it, because I know the truth. That's what protects us.
True. Very true. Couldn't agree more.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. How can you protect you and yours if you don't know what you're facing?
Exactly. Most folks, though, they'd prefer a comforting lie. Not me. I've seen firsthand
Good.
What the truth can do. My sister and I, we grew up way out in the Commonwealth. Tiny little settlement. Our dad, he was part of the local militia. Keeping the raiders off our backs and the Mire Lurks out of our latrines, as he'd describe it.
Well, nice.
One day, our dad turns up dead. His captain, asshole named Mayburn, claims raiders must have gotten him on watch. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. Turns out, the captain, he'd sold out. Thought he wasn't getting paid enough to babysit the town. He was gonna leave the gates
wow.
open one night, let a group of raiders sack the place and take a cut of the profits. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. I tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. So, I papered the entire town in posters. Wanted for gross dereliction of duty, Captain Mayburn. The mayor
well done.
To talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed.
Hey, save those people.
Piper, you saved those people.
No. Those people saved themselves. Because they knew the truth.
Because you told them the truth.
I'm sorry if I've been rambling. I just get fired up sometimes.
No, you're right.
It's just nice to talk to someone who actually seems to get it, you know? So, should we head out?
I think we should, yes. I don't know why she got all emotional there, but that's all right. Not a problem with me. All right, so yeah, so we gave her all my junk. Yes. There we go. So now Piper's carrying just about as much as she possibly can. Where's my left arm? What the heck happened to my left arm? Did I give you my left arm, Piper? Sorry, Piper. I accidentally gave you my left arm. Sorry about that. You can wear the Raider one, though. It looks kind of weird on you, but you know what? Give you a few extra protection there. There we go. That's what we were looking for. All right. Let's go, Let's not keep Nick waiting any longer than he's already been. And face Skinny Malone.
Come into my house, shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing game, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just...
Oh, you are a bitch, aren't you?
Should have left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood.
I feel like I should put... Hold on. I feel like I should pull out my... This thing.
In this vault, I'm king of the castle.
Let's give it a try.
And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now.
What? Some private dick?
I told you we should...
What are you talking about?
Then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about old times.
Dala, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Really?
Oh, yeah? Then what's this guy doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought him here to rub us all out.
No. Yeah, this... Yeah. What the hell's going on?
What's the deal with you people and Nick, anyway?
Darla's a runaway. Her father wanted me to bring her back home.
Okay.
Turns out she skipped town to be with my old pal Skinny Malone. Mob boss. Never thought he'd manage to scrape together a big enough crew to take over a vault. Guess life's full of surprises.
Yep.
Hey, who's running this show here? You got something to say? Say it to me.
And peacefully.
You and Nick know each other?
Yeah. It's troublemaker here. Used to be a real headache back in the day. Before we got kicked out of the old neighborhood.
Must have done this dance 100 times. Enemies are kind of the closest thing you get to friends in these parts.
Now quit stalling. You're gonna talk? Talk.
And what about...
This is all just a misunderstanding, Skinny. You know that. You let us walk, and we won't come back.
Like hell you won't. Don't you get it? All the other crews in the area will see this as weakness. Then they'll come for me.
Sorry. Time to give you both the hard goodbye.
Oh, shite. Okay. Oh, you're coming for me, are you, bitch? Coming for me! Ooh, cool sound. Alright, where are they? Where are they? Okay, they did some damage. Yes, they did. Easy, Piper. Easy. Come on. Got him. Come on, you bastards. Got him. Now is Fat Man the only one left? Come here, chubby. I've got a 12 gauge slug with your name on it. Take it in the face! Oh, yeah! Not sure it makes much difference, to be honest. He's run his course.
With Darla's parents when I tell them their daughter bit the big one. Well, at least the case is closed.
That's for sure.
There's a service ladder that should take us right to the surface.
Alright, cool. Follow you, my friend. Alright, so we have officially taken care of Skinny Malone and the gang. Not too bad, if you ask me. So now we're going to get out. Now what are we going to do after this? I guess we'll follow Nick back to Diamond City. I don't really think there's anything else to do other than that. So we shall see. But first of all, let's talk to our friend Valentine after we get a little water in ourselves here.
Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me anyway?
Your secretary.
Many people knew where I went.
Yeah, Ellie told me.
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about your son, Sean, how he went missing. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
All right. I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.
All right. Very cool. That's kind of a cool scene, actually. Nick walking down that alley. Well, I guess the big question is now, what are we doing next? I mean, I suppose it makes the most sense to head to Diamond City, but of course we could do this. Because we're actually kind of close to where the Freedom Trail happens to end. And this is, of course, up there, so that's a bit out of the way. That, we need to go all the way back to, yeah. And, let's see, combat zone, no, we don't want to do that quite yet. The Freedom Trail is the only thing I can think of doing at this point. Why have I not discovered Mosinor Plaza? We cleared the whole place. Yeah, whatever. But, yeah, you know what? I'm thinking we might follow the Freedom Trail. Sounds kind of fun. Saving synths. I mean, Nick's a synth, and he's a perfectly good guy. Well, so, I guess, at this point, Hubris Cox? That's kind of cool. Well, at this point, my friend, I think it is time to follow the Freedom Trail and see just where that trail might lead us. And so that is what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and follow the Freedom Trail and help that group called the Railroad. I'm not sure what they do, what their whole deal is, but I've heard that they save synths, and hey. Oh, man.
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use.
I have seen no reason to believe that hallucinogen. What the heck? Shut up.
Nothing there now.
Oh, that car is still gonna blow up. Yes, it is. Oh, yes, it is. Nothing like a good nuclear explosion to get the day going, eh? Who are you? Raider scum! Scum! Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Where the... the heck? These people are back. Or are they back, or they just come to check on their compadres? Yeah, interesting. All right, well, let's see. North. We need to go actually more east than north. All right, well, my friends, I believe we've had quite a good day. Don't you say, Miss Piper? Save Nick Valentine, and now we're going to follow the Freedom Trail. And so, due to prior knowledge, I'm going to go to Old North Church. One of the most historic and old churches in the entire United States. I've actually been there before. So, hopefully, we'll find a nice intact church with some nice group of highly intelligent and highly respected people. Ooh. Private property, no trespassing. What have we here? It's kind of a nice house. Cabot house. Gives me the creeps. Yeah, we'll come back here another day. But yeah, hopefully we will find a group of well-armed, well-equipped, and smart mercenaries who are saving sense and fighting the Institute to its core. And who knows? Maybe they can even help me find Sean. Alright, so here we are, Old North Church. Well, my friend Piper, I think it's time to go have a little chat with the railroad. Oh, and I'm the type of guy who will never settle down. Where pretty girls are, well, you know that I'm around. I kiss them and I love them, cause to me they're all the same. I hug them and I squeeze them, they don't even know my name. They call me the Wanderer.